So, ladies and gentlemen, to receive a special award from the Ireland Funds, which says, thank you for turning up. Please welcome the captain of the English team from that day, John Pullin.
Excuse me. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for that. Yet again, another standing ovation. They told me it was 5 minutes last time, so what's wrong this evening? Anyhow, I'd like to say thank you for inviting me here on the eve of what is going to be a great occasion tomorrow. I find that I'm up here under... I was told I would only have to turn up this evening, but it turns out I've got to make a speech as well. But it's only going to be a few very short words. I wasn't too impressed with the film show. But then someone remarked to me that it showed Keith Woods try three times. So that rather evens it out. But in my day, I would like to add that we weren't allowed to score tries like that anyhow. Anyhow, the reason I was here was obviously because of what happened 34 years ago. People have often said to me, they either think I was a fool or a hero. I'd like to think I would come somewhere in between. Because at the time, I don't think we honestly realised the seriousness of the situation, or at least I didn't. But it was fairly obvious to me, even, that if rugby relations were to resume, they had to be done very quickly. The longer it went on, I think the harder it would have become. So that was some part of my thinking in coming over to Ireland that year. But I suppose to take a bit of myth out of the theory, there was another reason why I did come, which was a very selfish reason, I must admit. And that was the fact that the English Rugby Union had said they were definitely coming whether I turned up or not. And there was no way that I was going to give up my England place. It meant that much to me. But these days, I do sometimes wonder when I see coaches sending on 5 or 6 players with 30 seconds left to play and they get a cap for that, which doesn't go down very well, quite honestly. Another reason, destroying the myth a bit, when I said that the England Rugby Football Union Committee were determined to come, I hate to tell you, but... the only reason for that was it was a big free weekend out for their wives and they wouldn't miss it for the world. And I must say, I can go along with that because there is no better place to spend a rugby weekend than in Dublin. It's an absolutely fabulous place. Looking back, I must say I was very pleased we did make the effort and come. And it was an absolutely fantastic reception for the crowd. And I must say, I didn't really appreciate what it meant to the Irish people. And I haven't really done so until the last 5 or 6 years, really, when it has been brought home to me how pleased they were to see us. I must say, if I was honest, we were a bit worried at the time, but it passed off without any incident whatsoever. And by the evening, we were going wherever we wanted in Dublin, doing what we would normally do after an international match. So we won't dwell on that any further. But having received a threat telling us not to go, then I realised that people who threaten never do anything anyhow. And so I have to let you into a secret. That was why we let Ireland win. And also... having written that bit of the speech about turning up, we couldn't win, could we? Anyhow, I'm sorry to say to you that it'll be no such luck tomorrow. I think England are bound to win, but as we all know, it's going to be a great day, and as long as it's a great game, I'm honestly not too worried who wins. But once again, thank you for this award, and it's been a pleasure to be here this evening. Thank you.